Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the GRE. We have been solving GRE math problems out of this book here, The Official Guide to the Revised GRE, the second edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today we'll talk about how to compare box and whisker plots. If you're given two or three whisker plots, what information can we extract from them? How do we go about comparing the two data set? Let's take a look at it. We're just going to put down two on the blackboard, and this data set that we're going to put down on the blackboard is very similar to what you will find on page number 273, example 4.2.6, except I made the figures a little bit more friendly, because the figures that they give you in the book are just insane. It's difficult to plot them, so let's begin here. The very first thing we're going to do is we're going to put out a scale. We're going to go all the way from 100, all the way up from 100 to 800. Let's see where it ends. So here's our 100, so here we go, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and somewhere here is our 800. This is 100. Let's plot the first one. So there we go. 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, and 700. The first list A, looks something like this. The story begins at 200 and ends at 750. The story ends at 750. And the 750. What does it tell you in itself? That tells us the range. It tells us that it begins at 200, it ends at 750. The range of the first list, even though we know nothing about it, we already know the range is 550. Because it ends at 750, begins at 200. Now we look at the quartiles. The first quartile, the second quartile, the third quartile. Okay, the first quartile is the point where 25% of the observations fall below it. 25% of the observations fall below it. And in this case, we have 300 here. The first quartile is 300. The third quartile, we're going to have 700. This is what is given to us. Then we are given one more information, which is the first quartile. This is the first quartile. This is the third quartile. We are given the third quartile, which is right here at 550. Right here. We're almost done. Now we close this box. This is what's given. This is what is given for the first box and whisker. We have to erase this line now. This is how it looks like. Well, let's plot the second one. Let's plot the second one and let's see what sort of observations we get from there. In the second one, the story begins at 250. The story begins at 250 and it ends at 700. So we draw a line like this. The point where the first quartile ends, the second quartile begins, the point where below which 25% of the observation lie, in this case, is 400. And the third quartile is 600. We're going to keep it simple. Now we close the box. Close the box. And now we have to locate the 50th percentile, the second quartile, the end of the second quartile, beginning of the third quartile, the point at which 50% of the observation lie below it and 50% of the observation lie above it. We are told that it is 550. Oh, I made a mistake. This one is 450. This one is 450 here. This, we are told, is 450. And the second one is 550. So let's fix everything up. We can erase this dotted line. We don't need it. We erase this dotted line. We don't need it. And this one was wrong. The 50th percentile, rather, but the first one is right here at 450. For the second one is at 550, right here. This is 550. Now we erase the line in between. That's it. We fix it up nicely and we are ready to compare the two box and whiskers. They're almost done. I'm going to put them in different color so they look a little bit better. There we go. And the second one looks something like this. Question is, if we were given something like this and nothing else, if we were given something like this and nothing else, what can we possibly say about it? Let's find out, shall we? Well, there's a lot of information we can extract from it. First thing we can extract is, since I don't have enough room here, I'm going to write one item at a time and we're going to have to erase it. So here's our list A. List A. And here's our list B. But the first thing we can extract, we already talked about it. First thing we can extract is the range. The range for the first one is from 200 to 700. From 200 to 750 rather. This ends at 750. It ends at 750, begins at 200. So range for first one is 750 minus 200, which is 550. What about for the list B? For the list B, it begins at 250 and it ends at 700. It ends at 700, begins at 250. Oh! It begins at 250. Don't tell me I made a mistake again. Oh, it begins at 400. It doesn't begin at 200. This one began at 200. It begins at 250. And it goes up to 450. It goes up to... Give me a second. The second one ends... I need my pointer, otherwise I can't speak. The second one ends at 700. The first one ends at 750. So that is correct. 750, 700. This one begins at 200, and this one begins at 250. So the difference should have been 50. No, the difference should have been 100, because not only it begins at 250 instead of 200, not only it begins at 250 instead of 200, but it also ends 50 before this one. This one ends at 750, this one ends at 700. So 750 minus 200 is 550, 700 minus 250 should be 450. Which makes perfect sense. As I said before, this one ends at 50 units later, this one ends at 700, this one ends at 750. This one begins at 200, this one begins at 250. It starts 50 units later and ends. This one starts 50 units later and ends 50 units early. So of course the range is going to be, difference in the range is going to be 100. What else can we say? We can talk about the first quartile. By looking at it, we can locate the first quartile, the point at which 25% of the observation lie below and 75% of the observation lie above it. For the first one, it's right here, it's 300. It's 300. For the second list, the first quartile is right here, which we said was 400. This point was 400. I don't want to plot the dotted line, but if you were to do that, this is 400. What about the median, which is the second quartile, which is same as the median, What can we say about the medians of the two lists? Well, median is located by this dark line. The median for this one, first one was, is 450, which means 50% of the observation lie below 450, 50% of the observation lie above the observation of 450. But for the second list, the median is 550. Median is 550. What about the third quartile? Well, third quartile is where the box ends. In this case, it is 700 in the first list, and the second list is very easy to see that it is 600. it is 600. Now finally, we can talk about the interquartile range. The interquartile range, let's put them up here. Interquartile range is the range of the middle 50% of the population. Range of the middle 50% of the population, which is the end of the third quartile, right here. End of the third quartile, in this case, it is 700. And the end of the first quartile, which is 300. So for the first list, the interquartile range is 400. Interquartile range is 400. What about the second list? In second list, we can see that the third quartile is at 600 and the first quartile is at 400. They were not lined up properly. I don't want to erase and rewrite everything. It looks ugly, doesn't it? 400, 550, 600. 400, 550, 600. 550, 600. So we have third quartile, the first quartile is 400. So the range of the middle 50% of the observation, the mid 50% of the observation, this is the mid 50% of the observation. Interquartile range shows us the mid 50% of the observation. The middle 50% of the observation for the first list is between 700 and 300. 700 and 300, 50% of the observation lies between these two values, between 700 and 300. And for the second list, the list B, in the list B, they lie between 600 and 400. Those are the things we can observe from it. So if they give you, if they give us two box and whisker plots, and they ask us two or three questions based on it, these are the sort of questions they will ask you. It may even show up as a quantcom problem. Why not? It might even show up as a quantitative comparison question, where they may give you two box and whisker, like just like this, on top of each other, in the middle of the two column, and they might ask you to compare the range, which column A, column B, range of list A, range of list B, or interquartile range of list one, interquartile range of list two, the median of this first list, median of the second list. They can ask any of these things. We can locate the quartile, we can locate the range, we can locate the 50th percentile, which is the median. So they might ask us to compare the median of list 1 versus the median of list 2. But this is all there is. This is how we extract it. I think that's all I have for, that's all I have here to say. I will see you tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll begin talking about the notion of dispersion versus central tendency. What does central tendency means? What does central tendency means? And what are some of the tools we have at our disposal? What are some of the tools we have to measure, to get the idea of central tendency in a set of data? And how do we go about measuring dispersion? There are three tools that we have that we can use to measure central tendency. And similarly, there are three tools statisticians have at their disposal to measure what is known as the dispersion. Three tools to measure the central tendency. Where is the data clustered? At what point does the data tend to cluster, and how widespread is it? Not widespread, how spread out is the data, which is the dispersion. And there are basically, and there are similarly three tools statisticians have at their disposal to help them measure the dispersion of observations. We're going to talk about those tomorrow, and then day after tomorrow we'll begin to actually calculate what is known as standard deviation, which is going to be day number 394. Today is day number 392, I believe. Let me just double check. Yesterday was 391, where we talked about interquartile range, and today is day number 392. Tomorrow, as I said, we're going to talk about those three concepts for central tendency and for dispersion, day number 393. And on day number 394, we'll finally actually calculate standard deviation for a given set of data. All right? I know.